a music producer, a DJ, and a market graduate. Mr. Kazi Gerwa.
What's up?
How are you?
I'm good.
Before we get into Kinderwasser, can you please tell us about your childhood background?
Oh, yeah. I was born in KZN. Grew up there and went to Empangeni, Sekhawini. And when I was 15, I moved to Mpumalanga from my high school, then moved to Secunda. And I had a crazy high school life, really, really crazy. And that's where I fell in love with music. And after that, when I was 19, I decided to study some engineering, what music production. Yeah, and I started in the... Am I moving too fast?
You're talking.
Yeah, born in KZN, yeah, it's a state of my mom, so it's by my mom in KZN. I have two siblings, and two sisters, older and younger sister. Then I also stayed in KZN, KwaZulu-Natal, Empangeni.
Yes,
yeah, when I was 15, that's when I moved to Mpumalanga. From Mpumalanga, I came to my high school day, and that's around the same time I fell in love with music.
Okay, so I
want to
know, where did it all begin? The
love for
music, DJing, and marketing?
When I was doing grade 10, I was at boarding school. So there was guys from Whitbank, what is it, best music, deep house. So we were like committing, who's going to put the best music and everything. So that's how I fell in love with house music. And by the time I was in the clique, I already knew that I wanted to produce house music, and I also want to be DJing. Yeah.
So, like, out of all the genres, we have hip-hop, why house music?
Actually, I tried hip-hop,
then
I realized that I'm not a good writer. I had a ghost writer when I was like 16. Mm-hmm. I was like, no, this is not what I'm looking for. Then house was just an excuse for me, and it's like club music, and I love club. Yeah.
Okay, so who was your, who inspired you?
Back in the day, it was guys like Dr. Duda, Black Coffee. Those were the guys I looked up to. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But then when I started producing, I was looking at people at my age who were already doing it. Capo, Florida Song, Shimza, Julian Gomez, those are the guys I was like, okay, these guys are at my age and they're already doing this. Well, what's taking me so long to kill a drive?
Okay,
and
so you started doing music at the age of
16,
right?
Back then I had a ghostwriter, I was trying to be a rapper. Okay. When I was 19, the train and I started knowing about the software side, the technical side of music production. Because I was already studying sound engineering and music production.
So how did you create yourself?
How did I create myself? Or how do I create myself?
How did you create yourself?
Actually, as I said, I love house. So when I started studying sound engineering, we had the workstation where we can produce anything. So there were guys who were teaching us. I was privileged. I managed to buy a studio when I was like 19. I bought a studio and I look at the smart guys who are really, really, really good. They got them closer to me and I became their friends. And every time I know it's alcohol and some other stuff I can't mention in the place. So I told you, guys, let's go to my flat. Let's go make music. That's where and how I did. But the basics, I was taught at school. Then we were using Reason 5. I started with Reason 4. After Reason 4, I started using Reason 5. And then Cubase, mastering engine, and then mastering software, which is the way that I wouldn't say I read music or I play music, but I'm a DJ also. Yeah, so I use the Reason to make music.
That's good. You've worked with Benita Beats, right?
No, Benita Beats, I've played, I've shared a stage with Benita Beats, but the vocalists I've worked with, it's Donna Shea from the US, mm-hmm. Stacy Roche from Spain, mm-hmm. Also with Keith from Whitbank, also with it's quite a lot of machine. Then I also worked with a producer from Zimbabwe, he's based in Canada now, Jason Music. And then I'm also working, currently I'm working with Cozy Pops. I was on DCP and also working with Diablo, but Diablo is a rapper, so I'm doing management here. Yeah.
Okay, there was a time in life.
Yeah.
I remember you told me that you were in school. What happened?
Oh, when I was 21, I was one of those guys who were exposed with money.
Yeah.
And the money was coming in, but there was no management. I already had a company when I was 21. So that's where I started getting big checks. So it was like, there was no management, I would go to Devin and say, yeah, let me go to Devin and do marketing research. and go there and blow like 20,000. Come back, let me go to Alexander and check out how the place, what's the market there, what kind of music are they, what kind of music they playing there, and blow another 20K there. So I was 21, I was young, I was exploiting with money. Then, and I was staying at the hostel, so the lifestyle was just expensive, with no management. So I started losing everything, breaking equipment. People started not taking me serious as a DJ and as a person who's carrying sound and doing events. Then everything just fell apart. That's when I decided, let me go back and study business. That's when I decided to do marketing.
Why marketing management?
Because I mentioned it's a brand. I have to know how to sell the brand. I have to know how to brand myself as an artist. I have to run my brand as a business. So those are the basic things I needed to know. Because when I first opened the company, I was 21, I knew nothing about business. I thought I had business in my club. Because from my family side, from my dad's side, everyone is business minded. So I thought I had to make that too. Let me just do this. But then there's a lot to it, so I have to financial, what. But all of this, yeah.
So you graduated this year, right?
Not recently, 2 years ago. Actually, it's my third qualification.
Really?
Yeah. Sound engineering, music business, and marketing.
Okay.
I still need maybe 1 or 2 degrees, then I'm done with education. Yeah.
Okay, like, I didn't really know that. When did you decide that music is the career for you?
When I was really young, when I was 15, I really knew that I wanted to do music. Because when I was 13, around 13, 14, I knew that Zwaibar and those guys from CKZ, they went to Drunken School Boys, and that's a school for music. So I wanted to go there, but then when my dad passed away, my mom was like, I'm not going to afford to take you there. So go to school, go to a normal high school, then after that you decide what to study. Yeah. Yeah, but when I was 16, I really knew that's why I want to do music.
Okay, that's interesting. So I
want to
know, when was your first paycheck?
I got my first paycheck when I was 20. It wasn't that much, but then I could afford to buy a car, but I didn't buy a car.
So what did you do with your first paycheck?
I blew it, man. With girls, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I blew with girls and friends. Like, as I said, I was that is the responsible kid.
Okay, so I remember I met you around
2014,
right? So you were living in Joburg, right?
Yeah.
Before coming to
Joburg,
right?
Yeah.
So how was the
change of? I mean, that was around the same time where I got broke, was that, yeah. Can't ask me for money for a school. Let me just go back home, finish this marketing thing, then I'm going to come back to Joburg later. So yeah, I studied the marketing management in Joburg, and I was like, okay, I can also do this from home. But when I go home, and don't pay rent, actually I'm getting food paid at home when I get there. I don't have to worry about all those things. Let me just go home and freshen up and come back to Joburg with more energy.
With more energy?
Yeah.
So you came back to Joburg around when?
2017 in the beginning.
Okay, I'm sure you don't say one thing to know the profile, right?
Yeah, I've done the rest of the time.
Yes. So you know the time.
Like Phyllis. To me, so I wouldn't say it's Phyllis because when I invest my time into something, it's always a return. My like, time is the most precious asset. If you waste rather waste my money than my time. So yeah, if I invest my time, then I think I got a lot to offer. If I come and offer this, I know that it's gonna, even if you don't return the favor to me, someone else is gonna feel that. Someone else is gonna see that, oh, what's so good? Yeah, so yeah.
So that's it. Can you please tell us about your achievement? The highlights.
The highlights. Getting a paycheck at the age of 20 with doing what I love. And being on 200, check source, and iTunes worldwide. That was a major achievement. And working with Donald Sheep, that guy is like a musical genius. But then I managed to work with him when I was 22. And we were talking charts on check source. Yeah. So that was an achievement. And there's also other achievements that I don't even remember.
You don't even remember that?
Yeah, I've been playing with one of the biggest guys from the United States.
So how was it like sharing this game with it was mind-blowing.
UW is a legend. I also share a stage with two of the songs, DJ Kenz. But when we said DJ Kenz, right now, I wasn't good with DJ. DJ Kenz is like really good. So I did go well, but then I would play the same stage with Kenz. Kenz was just making way sense. I was like, oh, Kenz is here, Kenz is here. But then I was cool, man. It was a cool experience. And then I shared a stage with a lot of other artists. Some of them are underground, yeah. Some of them are still upcoming.
So like, I'm looking at the industry right now, right? Yeah. And I feel like house music is, I won't say that, I don't know how it's going, but I feel like I'm a piano and go music that's taking over. I just feel like house
go,
music.
Go has been around. Uh-huh. Yeah. Deep house people and cold people are not competing. Uh-huh. And my piano is a subgenre of house. Uh-huh. So there's no competition. I always say I was competing with the current people, but I'm a piano. And I know my market and I'm a piano market, so they got their certain market. So I don't know who are these people creating a beef between deep house guys and my piano guys, but I don't have a problem with my piano. There's a guy who even told me one of my songs sounds like my piano. I was like, yeah, I didn't know. I only know that I'm doing deep house. So yeah, man, I'm a deep house kid.
No, I'm a little bit shy. Like I don't dream, but I don't even talk about my haters. I don't give him that attention. So yeah, I don't fit. Yeah.
So who are you currently working with?
Currently, I'm working with Sam Magic. Biago, Biago's from Nigeria. Sam Magic's from Mpumalanga, is one of the most talented producers I know in South Africa. He already worked with guys like Questa and STC and all those guys. And then there's Biago. Biago's from Nigeria. I'm managing him. Yeah, I also manage artists, by the way. And I'm also working with Uzi Forbes. Uzi Forbes is also from Nigeria, he's doing Afrobeat. Yeah, and I'm also working with Villain from Hypergenics. Yeah, I'm helping him with the music business. I'm also gonna do a song later this year. He's a hip hop guy. He was like, dude, I can do something on your house beat. Yeah, it's actually like one of my only legend friends I know, because he was in the industry before Squatter Camp. The guys from Squatter Camp were inspired by the group Hypergenics. Okay. Yeah, so I'm working with one of the guys from Hypergenics, yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to ask you this. Between Black Motion and Black
Coffee? Can I say a little bit of both? Because, okay, with live performances, I'll go for Black Motion. And with production, I'll go for Black Coffee.
So both of them?
Yeah, I can say, yeah, both of them, yeah.
Can I ask you this?
Yeah.
Louis Vega? Versus
Louis Vega. Louis Vega is a creative genius. To me, Vinny Tavitz is just a compiler and a good DJ, and he's also a legend. But Louis Vega is a good music producer. I'm only saying he's a hands-on producer, but I know if he's in studio doing music with him, yeah, he's gonna come up with something very nice. Yeah.
Very good.
Yeah.
So, who do you wanna work with?
Currently. I want to try mainstream actually, so Choma Jones is in mind. I know I did keep out, but then Choma Jones in mind, Something Soweto. I also want to work with Something Soweto. Who else? Dakapo. I want to work with Dakapo in Cuba, and Julian Gomez, Chezuela. Those are all the producers like I look up to. This guy should have a competition. Julian Gomez, Taka Folk, Cuba, two of the songs. And we actually had around the same age group. So I wouldn't look at the Madalas like Kumi Kufi. The Madalas, he's like 10 years older than me, so he's a Madala. Yeah, so I wouldn't look for those guys. They are part of the legends really. But then I'm looking at the guys who are at my age and who are already doing it. I don't know, I'm not doing it, but then yeah, those guys, they're from the mainstream, but they do keep us. Yeah.
So, between Okinawa and Kuken and Jessica, who would you like to work with? Because I know they're both, there's a tie.
That was a tricky one.
Yeah.
But of Kuken, it's Okinawa. Because I take the book, I'll go for Casper. Casper, your best. I know I'm Zulu. I was supposed to go with my baby brother, but I'm going to Casper Danish. I'll go for Casper. Casper, your best. But you're a little rapper.
Yes. Okay. How is music making
money? I mean, there's a lot of things in the music industry. I'm doing a lot of things. I'm doing music distribution online. Which is a lot of artists don't even know how to put their music on iTunes. So I can do that with a smartphone, 30 minutes easy, and make $1,000 on that. I can rent. So that's money. I also do a little bit of PR. Then music business consultation. Then I also get money from the artists. My music is selling like in Belgium, for a fan base in Belgium. And in Germany, France, there's people are buying my music, there's a demand for my music. So I get royalties from those areas. Here in South Africa, there's not a lot of people who know, hey, what's actually a music video?
Yeah.
I'm still working on it.
I also don't know.
But then I'm also still trying to do my, that's why I want to work with people like Choma Juice, who are like active in the dance scene. So just to be on the mainstream, then I can carry on doing my deep house. Yeah.
Okay. So since when I don't know about
Music production, I wouldn't say it is, but it's passion. Because when I first started, I was like, you can't do this thing, I can't do this thing. Then when I'm really like bored or something, I'll just go there, do a nice song. I'm like, okay, actually I can do this. Just have to do it every day and finish each and every single song like this. Then from there, I started developing more skills, started experimenting. And then from that, most of the people I associated myself with were music producers or vocalists. So I always make sure my friends are more talented than me so that I can learn from them.
So between DJing and
actually, till recently, my DJing skills were lacking. But now I'm balancing everything.
Yeah. So it's
not DJing? I'm there because I've got like more than 1,000 songs. Okay. I DJ almost every weekend. So I can say now I'm actually doing this on a daily basis and DJing and music production.
At the time you were still at Google, right?
You were
studying. How did you manage to
kind of study? I think the time I was like, let me just focus on I only DJed at parties when I went back home. I only DJed at parties. When I was about to come back to Durban, I was managing a club, and I was also a resident, which was just too much. Club bosses, they don't want to give you money. You make them 100,000 rand, then they give you 200 rand.
The funny thing is that me and now,
oh yeah, yeah. We don't have to promote this
club. No,
we don't have to promote them. Let them pay us, then we can mention them on TV. Yeah, we don't have to promote them.
So did you work at
that? Yes, actually, yes, I did play a couple of times in those clubs in ML. Yeah. But then I wasn't doing it for money because I was getting pressure from people. When I went back home, people who expected me to be like driving Mercedes Benz, being that top DJ and a producer. I'm like, hey, yo, boss, we've got a deal for you here. You come through. I was like, hey, guys, I'm going to be prepared. No, come through, just come play. Then I'll sort of set up and get music together, go play. It wasn't something I was like. I was like chilled out, just doing music. Because I never stopped producing, but DJing, I stopped DJing for like 2 years. Yeah.
About the person that you
can see, he's an amazing singer, man. Mm-hmm. From Nigeria. He's young and he's energetic. We just shot his music video on Monday. We shot his music video. His product is really cool for the industry. He's going to be busy with PR stuff now. So I'm going to be plugging his music. What else do you want to know about him? He's a Nigerian artist, Afrobeat. He's young. And it's good actually, yeah.
So what can we expect from
you?
In the future.
I wanna open a record label. Mm-hmm. I wanna do annual events like festivals. Mm-hmm. And I also wanna print my brand as an artist and build my brand, my company brand. Yeah, what else? And I want to help more artists to understand the music industry, because people just want to put their music online and then they think we want to buy their music. There's a lot of marketing to be done, a lot of PR to be done, and it's not an easy industry. I personally, I wouldn't let my child to be in the music industry. And then he's super talented. He has to be super talented. He has to have a degree in music if he or she wants to study a career in music. Because music, it's not a thing that you can rely on. That's why I'm doing a lot of things. I'm not just doing music. I'm also doing marketing. So DJ. Okay, DJ is not so bad.
Wait, do you have a full-time job or you just...
No, I quit. I was doing sales. I was like,
you're doing sales?
I did sales for like 2 years.
The
time I quit, I was selling oxygen.
Oxygen.
Yeah, Umoya. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so I was selling oxygen. I was like, no, what the hell is happening now? I'm selling oxygen. I'm like, no, let me go focus on music. Like ozone oxygen, yeah.
Okay, yeah.
Yeah, ozone oxygen. Yeah.
So you decided to quit?
Yeah, I also sold charity, I sold credit cards, mm-hmm. I sold supplements, so yeah.
Supplements?
Yeah, supplements for like health supplements. Yeah, something like that. Yeah. So yeah, I sold almost everything. And when I was selling oxygen, oxygen, I'm like, no, I'm done with sales. Okay, I can sell. I can sell. Let me go sell my bread. Yeah.
So Mama Natima, quite
network the community for the community. I don't want that much, man. 1.5 million is enough.
So that's for this.
Yeah, that's actually a capital for me to start next year. It should be a capital.
Okay,
1.5 million is enough.
Okay. So for somebody who has that problem,
Guys, don't do drugs. Yeah, guys, don't do drugs. Don't do drugs, guys. I know they kill a lot of my friends, kill a lot of careers. Don't do drugs. Stay focused at school. Stay focused at school. Yeah, school. School is important. Yeah, I know. I wouldn't say I love school. I have to go to school, but then. Yeah, I learned a lot of school, a lot of things at school. I'm something like I didn't even go to school yet. But then, when you're dating a school, not just about the books, even the way that communication, this communication, you get one another as well. Yeah, we put the school in, I put the study, I put the money in. Yeah. School, stay away from drugs.
Okay. Right now,
Susanna,
so
you use
the
freeze,
right?
Yes.
So, you're
going
to choose it.
Your best,
I'm a piano or
drum? None of the above. Okay, can you change it? Maybe you make home and deep house. None of the above.
It's obvious, though.
No, piano, no. It's a no, for piano, for me, it's a no. When I'm on a bit tipsy, I drink home.
Okay, so Ray Perry or
Steve? Oh, I know those guys are legends, but I don't know their music. I'm being honest.
Oh, wow.
I know that they're legends, but then I wouldn't tell which song is it. Or, yeah.
Have you ever
and I actually had an opportunity to work with Woman Lobo from Woman Lobo. No, from Mr. Man. I didn't get that from Mr. Man. I had a publishing deal which shared music a couple of years ago, before I terminated the contract. So they gave me, I think it was Mr. Man acapellas to remix. So I did a song, when I was about to release the song, I didn't know anything about music business. Well, when I went to ask that, and they were like, no, we're taking 60% of everything for the next 10 years. When I was like, no. I'm the one doing the music. You're just taking 60% to the station. I was like, okay, take your vocals and everything. I'll go
by way. Okay.
The last one.
Trompet for chicken. Chicken. Yeah. No. So crazy. If I'm not going to go to a computer, I'll get a baby.
Instagram, it was in game. Twitter, it was underscore game. Facebook was in game. LinkedIn was in game. Actually, the easiest way to get me just goes to Google Kwazi Ngema. Everything, like my music is there, and my profile is there, everything is there, even the phone numbers. When I Google, everything is there. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay,
all the content is there. Yeah.
Okay, South Africa, thank you very much.
Africa, thank you.
Creating
real
entrepreneurship,
achieving more.